Hello everyone, Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com, and in this video I'm going to show you how you can play audio within a voice channel. I'm also going to be showing you how you can have your bot connect to a voice channel whenever you run a command. So on the left here, we have this basic project I've been working on throughout this series. If you want access to this, a link to this will be in the GitHub repository, which you can find in the video description. Also, if you need help with anything, feel free to leave a comment down below or ask in the warrenoffkeys Discord server, and I'm sure someone will be able to help you there. So with that said, let's get started. I'm going to be using the Commando framework. And if you don't know how to use the Commando framework, I do have a video on that, and that could be linked in the video description as well. So I'm going to go inside of my MISC folder, and here I have this very basic intro.m4a audio file. It's just me doing my classic, hey, it's Alex here from warrenoffkeys.com intro, and so we're going to be playing this audio within Discord. So I'm going to make a new file here. This one will be called play-audio.js. And this is going to be your actual command. So within Commando, to actually register a command, you have to first create a class that extends commando.command. So with that said, we have to import Commando. So constant commando equals require discord.js-commando. And then we're going to export a class. So module.exports equals class. We can say play audio command. And this class is going to extend the functionality of another class, and that is commando.command. Now at this point, this class is going to have all the functionality that a basic command would have, and then we can use that functionality to then create our actual command. So we're going to start off with a constructor, which is going to be ran whenever a new object of this class is made. And so within here, we also want to call the constructor of our command class, which is something we're extending, and to do that we can use super. This is going to take in two arguments. The first one is the client, which we have from our constructor. The second one is an object, which will contain some options. The first option can be name, which is going to be play audio. And the second one is going to be group, which I'm just going to say MISC because we're in the MISC folder. Third can be member name, which will also be play audio. And then we can have our description, which will be plays some audio. You can add in whatever you want there. We're then going to have an asynchronous run function, and this is going to be ran whenever the command is actually ran by a member. We want access to the message argument, which the run function provides for us. And first we're going to try and just get this bot to actually join a voice channel with us. So we need to first get access to the voice channel. So we can destructure that, so constant voice equals message.member. And then we want to see if voice.channel ID is undefined or not. If it is undefined, that means that the user that ran the command is not within a voice channel. So I could say if not voice.channel ID with a capital I and a capital D. We can then complain to the user because whoever ran the command is not in a voice channel. I could then say message.reply, you must be in a voice channel, and then I can return. Now at this stage, after the if statement, we know that the user is in a voice channel. So I could do voice.channel.join, and this should have the bot actually join the voice channel. So if I save this and I run the bot with node index.js, I can then go into Discord and I could try running play audio. It'll then say you must be in a voice channel. I can then join the tutorial channel and then I can run play audio. And now my bot joins the voice channel. So I'm going to disconnect this and I'm going to disconnect myself. Now we want to actually play some audio, but there's something we have to do before that. There's actually two things. The first is we have to install ffmpeg, which is actually fairly simple. A link to this will be in the video description, or you can go to ffmpeg.org, and then we can go to download. You want to select your operating system. I'm on Windows, so I'm going to click on here, and then everything here should be the same. You want to make sure that if you're on a 32-bit machine that you select this, otherwise keep it at 64. And you can click on download build. Now this is going to give you a .zip file. And once you have that .zip file, you want to extract it into your C drive under ffmpeg right here. So if I directly go into here, you are then going to see the bin, doc, and presets and all these types of files right here. So we want to have for a C drive, ffmpeg/bin to go into these exe files. So on Windows, we just have to copy this right here. I want to actually add this as an environment variable. So I can go into my environment variables. I can search up environment variables within Windows. We have to edit the environment variables. We could then click on environment variables right here. And we want to scroll down to where we see path. We then want to click on edit. And we want to make sure that FFmpeg is added to your path right here. Make sure the bin is there as well. So after that, you can close all of these things. And then now we can actually go through and play audio. But there's something we have to install when it comes to npm. So I'm going to stop the bot and I'm going to run npm install discord.js/opus. This is something that Discord has to allow us to actually play audio within Discord. Okay, so now we can actually go through and play audio. So we have to first import the path package, which is installed on Node.js by default, so we don't have to install it ourselves. So const path equals require path. Now, after we've joined the channel, this is going to give us a callback. So I can use .then, and this is going to have its own function. And this function is where we're going to actually play the audio, and the .then is going to give us a connection argument. Now within this callback, I can then say connection dot play, and we're going to use path.join to specify the path. The first argument will be the dir name, which will be the current absolute path for the directory that we're in, which in this case is the misc folder. And the second one is going to be the actual file name, which is the exact capitalization. So intro with a capital I dot m4a. I'm going to then save this and I can run my code with node index.js. Then going into Discord, if I run play audio after I'm in a channel, so exclamation point play audio. So it's now playing my intro. I'm not sure if you can hear that, but this means that it is now going to play whatever audio you want. And so this is how you're going to play audio within a voice channel using Discord.js. Thanks for watching this Discord.js tutorial. If you want to learn more about Discord.js, consider clicking on the playlist you see on your screen now. If you need help, feel free to leave a comment or ask in the Warnoff Keys Discord, which can be found in the video description.